Field here in Green Bay. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Chicago Bears and the Green Bay Packers. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Rodgers now on first down. He's got time. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jarrell Freeman. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. But now the Bears coming out as they get ready. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge. Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
The play fake. He'll look to throw. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Jake Ryan in there to sack him for a loss of six.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this will remain a scoreless game. Well, that opening drive looked good for a moment there, but they'll wind up being turned away thanks to the missed field goal.
And those especially hurt when you come into a game on the road. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
The first carry now. This is Lacy. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Well, in week six, they weren't sure if Lacy was going to play. He did suit up, 17 carries, 65 yards.
And James Starks, unable to play, normally his backup. So they had to be creative. Randall Cobb became a running back. Ty Montgomery, another receiver, became a running back. But Lacy did carry the load and gave it a pretty good effort.
They go play action here on first down. He completes it to Jordan Nelson. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Now a first down carry. It's Lacy. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, the one concern I had about Eddie Lacy coming out of Alabama was weight. And it became a concern for Green Bay in 2015.
Yeah, he was up over 260 pounds. Disappointing 2015. Looks a lot better, doesn't it?
A lot better. And when he's lean, oh boy, is he a heck of a runner.
Rodgers to throw on second down. In the middle of the field, he's got Nelson. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. And a look now at Nelson, who remains down. He appears to be shaken up a bit. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Yards to go here on third down.
Reset. Hey,
easy. They'll try and run for it. Here's Lacy. And he'll get nothing out of that one. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard.
Third and two, and they ran the ball for only 1 yard, and everybody's going to scream at the offense. Well, let's give a lot of credit to the defense on that play. Defensive front out leveraged the offensive line. They got more people to the football. Yeah, they won that battle in a big way, and they're forcing a big decision now by the guys on offense.
And Crosby puts it through. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So they get the ball first here in front of the home crowd, under the lights, and they get 3 points out of it.
And there's something about a night game, isn't there? A little extra snap, a little extra crisp in the air. What a terrific way to get things started. A little extra excitement, a little extra dazzle for the home crowd.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. Set to return now. Here's Deontay Thompson. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Surveying the field. He's got that one complete to Eddie Royal. A good pickup there, a 22.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play action pass, and completing it.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Brandon Garden, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Now Hoyer. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down. You know, we saw some fun things around the NFL in week six. You had a nose tackle, Dontari Poe, get into the end zone. Kobe Fleeter, a tight end, ran a sweep into the end zone. Interesting week.
The college game does have an influence on the NFL. Kobe Fleeter, that was a jet sweep that normally you see in the college game more than anywhere else. Dontari Poe, they use him really as like an extra tight end, and he caught a pass, really became a lateral, and he dove in. How about in Buffalo? Well, I saw an option.
Jeremy Langford. Touchdown, Chicago! Jeremy Langford, 55 yards, and the Bears have retaken the lead. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here, he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy, who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that. Super toe.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Packers. Randall Cobb, 70 yards. And the Packers have retaken the lead. That was a nice little setup there off play action for the long touchdown pass.
Yeah, I've got to tell you, it brings back bad memories for a guy like me as a former defensive back because in a playbook I knew a long time ago, we described that play pattern as draw pass nine go, meaning fly pattern after the play action pass, try and hit him for the deep ball, and boy, were they successful on that one. So tough because his speed is so great. You've got to make sure you don't miss any cues or keys in order to try and keep up with it.
Draw pass nine go. That's still a nightmare to this day.
Yeah, I still wake up in the middle of the night and feel the guy going past me.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Langford again. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
2 yards gets them back to where they started, but now third and 10.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Green, 39.
Hoyer. He's got time in the pocket. And Jeffrey's got it. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. A gain of 13 and also a first down. Alshon Jeffrey, so dangerous even when a defender's near him.
He's got such a big body. Ability to run, positions himself well, excellent control. And you're exactly right. Even if people are draped on him, he often comes up with the catch. He really symbolizes what people are looking for in receivers in today's NFL.
And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it'll be a Chicago first down. A good-looking run there by Jeremy Langford.
And what I've always liked about him has been not just his versatility, but his perseverance. I think he's one of those backs that gets better as the game goes on and he gets increased carries. does have some good toughness running inside. I remember when he was at Michigan State, at one point I did a game of his. He was listed as third team left corner, but cornerback, receiver, and running back for the Spartans.
Won a couple of Big Ten titles there as well. Hoyer finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
Here we go now.
First down, he'll drop to throw. This will be caught at the 2. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
And we've got movement. I think this is against the Bears here. Let's find out. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Marquise Wilson, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Bears have once again taken the lead.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Already looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. Now it's Hyde on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now the Packers get set to go. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Rodgers now on first down. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Rodgers now on first down. Over the middle, and and it's incomplete. He was looking for Ty Montgomery that time. And partner, I know we've done some division talk, looked at different races, particularly the NFC East. What else besides NFC East is catching your eye now?
I can't help it. It's the AFC South. I came into the year thinking this was a division with a lot of intriguing storylines, and they had a great offseason. I wanted to see how it would develop. Well, Houston beats Indianapolis last Sunday night. And if that game is reversed, if Indianapolis wins, then every team in that division has three losses. Amazing what's going on there. It will be tightly contested all the way through.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Bears are electing to call a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now the second-year man from Buffalo, Jake Schumm, on to punt. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Bears take over. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They'll run with Langford to begin the drive. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. And to the left side here, Wilson. And he's brought down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So here we go, first and 10
single
now.
Receiver.
They isolate Jeffrey to the left side. Now Hoyer, Miller on the catch over the middle. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. And Barth puts it through. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So a good kick that time, and he's able to redeem himself from the previous miss.
And fortunately for him, he got the chance to do that not long after missing the first time. Sometimes a whole game goes by, and you don't get that chance at all. So you keep it with you till the next time you take the field.
Barth now after the made field goal to kick it away. On the return, this is Micah Hyde. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we reach halftime with the visiting Bears out on top here as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Look at the spin. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Well, partner, we're through week six, so let's stir that MVP pot. Who are you liking right now?
Sam Bradford, Minnesota. Ezekiel Elliott, Dallas. Julio Jones, Atlanta. Matt Ryan, Atlanta. Dark horse, Dak Prescott. In Dallas, and you have to give the defense some love. What about Von Miller?
Yeah, Von Miller too, but how about that? A couple guys from Atlanta, a couple from Dallas. Those offenses humming right now. And they're able to get this one across the 35. This is Langford on first and 10. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They keep it on the ground with Langford. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Hoyer. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes where people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because
that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two. As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Second down following the incompletion. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. And he goal line. Here's Rodgers. He'll set up the screen to Lacy. A nice gain of 21 yards.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front. Completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Well, during the last commercial break off air, you and I were going back and forth comparing who's done well in the receiving game so far across the league. Who do you have down through week 6?
Well, Julio Jones, of course. Remember that big game against Carolina where he had, what, 300 yards plus receiving? I mean, he was a monster in that one. A.J. Green continues to be one of the best receivers in the league. Amari Cooper continues to develop for Oakland. And how about Greg Olsen in Carolina? A tight end on that list. He's number 2 in the league right now in receiving.
No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10.
And that run was memorable for only one reason. There was absolutely no place to run with the football. No gaps, no creases, no gain.
10 yards to go on 3rd. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. From the gun on 3rd down, Rodgers. It's caught, Nelson. And he's brought down after a good game. And that one results in 35 yards.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that 3rd down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a 1st down.
3rd time's a charm, right? 2 incompletions. Had to have it on 3rd, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Now Rodgers will handle Lacy. And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30. A good run there on 1st down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2.
This drive is turning to an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They go play action for Lacy. Now Rodgers. The left side throw complete to Adams. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right, Gavin. Guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
They come out here in the eye. Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. 2nd down. A lone 2nd remains now in this 3rd quarter.
Hey, hey, hey. We got 3. 3 down. 3-19.
Back to the ground. It's Lacy. And he'll be taken down after a minimal pickup, and that will take us to the end of quarter number 3. An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7.
Hey, check 26.
They'll run here. This is James Starks. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down.
3-19.
Now Rodgers got to have this one. He's got his target. It's Cobb. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Randall Cobb. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And now a critical extra point attempt here. And an important one that is, as we are tied now early in this 4th quarter. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This one fielded at the 5. Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at him turn.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Onto the field now come the Bears. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
The drive starts with a carry by Langford. And some space here. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. Give him 16 on the pickup. And it'll be first down, Bears.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. And they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Here's Hoyer, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. And there, the man coverage, not good enough, partner, and they're able to complete the pass.
Excellent recognition of the man coverage, and they found the guy who could win downfield.
Let's see if they can convert here on 3rd and 3.
Here we go now. Green three.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Rodgers again here on 2nd and 10. This is Montgomery with a grab over the middle. 7 yards on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary.
And look out, I think he's going to go. Touchdown, Packers. Jared Cook, 73 yards. And the Packers have moved out in front.
Did you see them hold up 4 fingers at the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
And they will take a 7-point lead now. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover and wow, now you got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
And 15 yards there on the catch and run.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route. And then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Complete here. He was looking for Zach Miller as tight end there. That'll bring up second down. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. The lone setback is Langford. Back to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now.
Let's go. 3-19.
He'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now as he's on to punt for Chicago. Oh, they come after him, and it's blocked. Now they can run with it. Picked up inside the 35. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the lead. Still a one-possession game, but the defense got to stop. They've got the football now. Just salted away, right?
Exactly. That's all the defense is counting on from their offense.
And now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they die. And now the Bears going to signal for another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They need to get this to the 24 on third down. They'll come out in the pistol. Rodgers to throw. He's got Adams on the hookup. And he's brought down after a good game. timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Rodgers throwing here. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's Tracy Porter with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. They'll look to throw. And to the left side here, Wilson. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. A good pickup there, a 22. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They have no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times have we seen it happen where you know it, yet a guy's still looking for a timeout or trying to stay in bounds? He got it done.
Hurry up, here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Back to throw. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he's brought down after a good gain. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. He's back to throw. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Back to throw. And this is caught at the 8. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They isolate Jeffrey to the left side.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Ah! He'll look to throw. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. This will be play number 8 on the drive. It's third and goal. They'll run here. This is Kadeem Carey. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. And no, it's incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt, and the Packers are going to win this football game. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. The clock cannot be stopped here. Defense can't do anything. So kneel it down, take it home.
No doubt about it. It's what you practice for in winning situations each and every week. Victory formation. Take a knee and go on into the locker room and celebrate.
Call it a victory. They begin the drive with Lacy. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
It's really come into vogue to talk about the different gaps that a defense tries to attack in an offensive line. And most of the time we're talking about blitzes. How many times have you heard double A-gap blitz? But where is the A-gap? It's the space between the center and the guards, either side. So when you're having a double A-gap blitz, that's two guys coming through that gap. In this situation, though, that A-gap wasn't open for the defense to exploit. The offensive line took care of it, protected it, and moved the defensive guys out of the way to allow for that nice run.